Good day, children. Saira, how are you all? Children, what did we learn in the previous period of value education? Come on, tell me, do you remember? Yes, we have learned about Florence Nightingale in chapter 5. Okay, today we are going to continue. Children, first I'm going to do a quick recap what we have learned in the previous period. After that, we'll do the textbook activity. So children, you're going to listen to teacher carefully, because after the recap, I'm going to ask you the questions. Okay? Shall we start? Florence Nightingale was born in Italy on 12th May 1820. Her father treated her as his friend. He educated her. Florence wanted to serve the entire world. She wanted to become a nurse. But her parents were totally opposed. But at last, they gave her permission to train as a nurse. After the training, she was appointed as a superintendent of a hospital in London. She got the opportunity to serve the wounded soldiers in Crimean War. She improved the quality of sanitation, did all type of work there in the hospital. There was no electricity to check the patients, so she carried a lamp. As she walked the halls of the battlefield hospital and came to be known as the lady with the lamp, she improved the quality of nursing and also found the Nightingale School and home for nurses. She was known as the founder of modern nursing. Florence Nightingale died in London on 13th of August 1910. Okay, so in short, I'd explained to you about Florence Nightingale. Children, now we'll start with the textbook activity. Answer the following. When did Florence Nightingale find the opportunity to serve? Come on, tell me. When did Florence Nightingale find the opportunity to serve? Come on, tell. When, in Crimean War, the wounded soldiers were affected by cholera and malaria, at that time, Florence Nightingale found the opportunity to serve. Again, when did Florence Nightingale find the opportunity to serve? When, in Crimean War, the wounded soldiers were affected by cholera and malaria. At that time, Florence Nightingale found the opportunity to serve. Okay, next one. Children, you are going to write this question and answers in your notebook. Okay, number two. Why is Florence called as the lady with the lamp? Why is Florence called as the lady with the lamp? Come on, tell me. Just now I told you why she was called as a lady with the lamp. Yes. There was no electricity to check the patients. So, Florence carried a lamp. As she walked the halls of the battlefield hospital and came to be known as lady with the lamp. Again, I'm repeating. Why is Florence called as the lady with the lamp? Answer is, there was no electricity to check the patients. So, Florence carried a lamp as she walked the halls of the battlefield hospital and came to be known as lady with the lamp. Okay, next question. Number 3. How did nursing job become a noble profession? How did the nursing job become a noble profession? Answer is, the caring heart of Florence won her admiration and affection of not just the soldiers she nursed, but of the entire world. It was this caring she brought to the job that made nursing a noble profession. How did the nursing job become a noble profession? The caring heart of Florence won her admiration and affection of not just the soldiers she nursed, but of the entire world. It was this caring she brought to the job that made nursing a noble profession. Okay, shall we move to the next question? Now, I'm going to do the fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. First one. Florence Nightingale was born in the year. Which year she was born? Can you tell me? Florence Nightingale was born in the year. Yes. 1820. When was she born? The year 1820. Florence Nightingale was born in the year 1820. Second one, Florence wanted to serve the dash and the dash. Florence wanted to serve the dash and the dash. Come on, tell me. Florence wanted to serve the soldiers and the entire world. Florence wanted to serve the soldiers and the entire world. Okay. Number 3. Florence took training in various hospitals in dash and dash. Florence took training in various hospitals in Germany and London. Florence took training in various hospitals in Germany and London. Fill in the blanks. First one, Florence Nightingale was born in the year 1820. Number 2, Florence wanted to serve the soldiers and the entire world. Number 3, Florence took training in various hospitals in Germany and London. Okay? Next one. It's activity time. Are the following statements true or false. The statements are true, you'll write true. The statements are false, you'll write false. So, read the question properly, okay? Read the sentence properly and then answer, okay? The first one is, women should do the cooking at home and not men. Is the statement correct? Women should do the cooking at home and not men. Why only women should do the cooking at home? No, men also can do, no? So, women should do the cooking at home and not men. The statement is false, right? False. Okay? Both can do the work, cooking work. Number two, girls cannot become pilots or soldiers. Girls cannot become pilots or soldiers? Yes, they can. Girls can become pilots or soldiers. So, here what is given? Girls cannot become pilots or soldiers. So, statement is true or false? It is false. Number three, boys are better than girls at studies. Yes, boys are better, always better than the girls at studies. No, girls are also better. So, boys are better than girls at studies. Tell me this statement is true or false? It is false. Girls are also good in studies. Right? So, boys are better than girls at studies. The statement is false. Number four. Only girls cry or feel frightened. Why? Only girls cry and feel frightened? No. Boys also, no? They also have emotions. So, only girls cry or feel frightened? Is this statement right? Is it true? No, it is false. So, only girls cry or feel frightened is false. Again, I'll read. Women should do the cooking at home and not men. Answer is false. Girls cannot become pilots or soldiers. False. Number three, boys are better than girls at studies. False. Number four, only girls cry or feel frightened. False. Okay, move to the next one. Now, match the following. Match the following. Now, see here. We can see on the right hand side, you can see the pictures. They are the our helpers. Who are they? Our helpers. And the names are given on the left hand side. So, you have to write, match the names with the picture, with the helpers. Okay. Now, first one is Mason. Can you see where is Mason? Yes. Here. Okay. This one is Mason. So, we will draw line, join. See here. This one is Mason. Okay. Then carpenter. Where is carpenter? Carpenter is here. Right? Match. Where is the teacher? The teacher is hiding here. So, but I'll join and show you. Teacher picture is here. We cannot see. Okay. Then where is doctor? Doctor is here. Match doctor. Okay? Match. Draw the lines. Next one. Okay. Again here, right hand side you can see two helpers are given. Pictures of helpers are shown. And the right hand side names. Sweeper and newspaper vendor. Okay, now show me where is sweeper. Match to the sweeper. Where is sweeper? Sweeper is here. And newspaper vendor. Okay, where is newspaper vendor? Is here. Now who are they? They are all our helpers. Okay. Next one. Now children, I'm going to give you one homework. Okay, you're going to write this in your notebook. What is the homework? What would happen if the following people do not perform their duties? Now, if the sweeper, postman and doctor, if they won't perform their duties, then what will happen? Okay, that you have to write 2 to 3 lines. Okay, what would happen if the following people do not perform their duties? Like sweeper, postman and doctor, if they don't perform their duty properly, then what will happen? Okay, that you have to write. So children, we have ended with today's period and we'll meet in the next period with a new chapter. Okay, till then, have a nice day. Bye.